So this cube is full of magnets, it's just crazy. It turns on its own, it's simply unbelievable. This is how the cube turns, only due to the magnets. Hey everyone, that's Cubastic, and today we review one of the most expensive and really cool Rubik's cube. The technology here is so modern that even in the name of the Gen 12 MagLev cube, it is indicated that magnetic levitation is present in the construction technology of this cube. You heard it right, it's magnetic cube. Today we will find out how this technology is implemented and how it allows you to solve this Rubik's cube faster. You have already seen the unpacking on the channel, here is the standard set for this configuration, but let's look again at what we have here. This box contains accessories that we will definitely get back to. Full of instructions, explanations, cards and much more. And another interesting thing is a bag in which you can store a cube. A nice bonus, but this is not the main thing. The main thing is the cube itself. The cube is in a transparent plastic box, looks decent. The first impression that this cube gives is decent. It looks really cool. And this is exactly what the flagship among Rubik's cubes should look like in 2022. This cube, unlike most of its competitors and past models, has a glossy surface. It is shiny. This is a new step in the production of cubes, because before that, manufacturers tried to make its surface as matte as possible in order to hide all scratches and fingerprints. I wonder what material is used here. And will the fingerprints be seen here? It feels like I'm touching the screen of a smartphone, as if the cube has a special anti-fingerprint coating. I'm trying to leave prints on the surface of the cube, but they are not appearing, and when I look closely, there are no fingerprints. Let's see if the scratches are seen, but this is not the main thing for now. The main thing for us today is to figure out how it turns and how magnetic levitation works. In general, there are a huge number of different cubes, each of them differs in its price, in its functions. You can learn the difference between all Rubik's cubes at thecubicle.com. There you can compare them, see how one differs from the other, and make a choice for yourself. After all, this store has an incredibly large assortment of not only Rubik's cubes, but also a wide variety of puzzles and accessories for them. You can easily purchase Gen 12 MagLev there too. Fast delivery to any corner of the earth and excellent quality of goods will not leave you indifferent. Go to the site, link in the description. Don't forget to use my special promo code Cubastic to get a discount on your order. At every turn, you can feel that it's worth all the money spent. Just look. We make one movement. Be careful, the cube also turns itself if you didn't finish the move. Let's take a closer look. So we make a turn of any face to the middle, half of a turn, and then I just lightly touch the side and it goes back into its place. Let's check again. I don't know how it works, but the technology is pretty interesting. This allows you to control the edges of the cube even at high speed. Or rather, the cube itself controls the movement. And if I turn it really quickly, without even turning some edge, the cube will do it itself. But unfortunately, this is not noticeable at high speed. And here is another interesting thing. If suddenly the cube doesn't turn the edge, for example, the edge will remain in this position, and we will turn the next one, then the cube will still allow us to do this. As you can see, this may be done even with the big angle. There was such a problem in the old cubes that if we were inattentive and scrolled the edge to such a position, the cube could simply fall apart. But here it's no longer possible, I can't even feel the resistance. It's interesting, but it's not the main feature of this cube. Magnetic levitation is used in every center here, but what does it affect? Well, it affects the fact that while turning it fast, I practically don't feel any friction. There are many elements here, there are many parts that touch each other, and naturally friction should occur during the turning. This causes resistance, but I cannot feel it here. It's like the sides are independent of each other, like they don't touch each other. It feels like I'm turning something in the air. So easy, I can develop quite a good speed. And don't even look at what I have in my hands. I can feel this cube in my hands, but I feel absolutely no resistance when I make movements. I can turn it even with my little finger. It's so easy. No other cube is so easy to turn. In order to test all these technologies in action, let's solve a Rubik's cube. Let's see how long it will take me and what emotions I'll gain. 3, 2, 1, go! Everything goes so easily. I absolutely don't feel any resistance. I'm not thinking too much about each and every move. The cube does all the work for me. It seemed to be solving on its own in my hands. During the turning of this cube, it becomes clear that it is also lighter than its competitors, although it seems to me that it has no competitors. I solved hundreds of different cubes, and the turn of each of them can be somehow characterized and compared with something. But when I turn this cube with magnetic levitation, the friction is so minimal that I almost don't feel the cube in my hands. What an interesting feeling! And during the solving of the cube and moments of selecting algorithms, the cube does all the work for you. It is solving on its own in your hands. That's all. I've been thinking too much in some parts, but the timing is good enough for me. This is so cool, but how does it work? Let's figure it out now. To do this, we will take the cube apart. We remove its center. It is not easy to do that. Here there are magnets. Inside we see a huge blue puck, which is located here. It moves here. Something repels it from below, because you cannot really press it down. In a regular cube, springs are used in any of its 3x3 or 4x4 versions. They burst the cube in different directions, like this. This is necessary to reduce friction, but the spring touches the center and the crust. And at these two points, when you turn the cube, the spring itself creates friction. Sometimes this causes an unpleasant squeak, but here, as you can see, there is no spring. It's time to check the little box. It contains a set of tools to disassemble this cube and customize it. First, let's use this key. It should help us remove the central element. I really don't know how, but it should help us to unscrew this element. Let's try. Something clicked. And the magnet detached. As you can see, there is a magnet inside, there's a magnet outside, and due to the fact that they are located with the same polarity towards each other, they simply cannot be combined together. It works the same way as a spring. To prove to you that there's magnetic levitation here, look, a real miracle will happen now. The magnet repels from the one located inside. It's not magic and not video editing, it's not glued to my finger. It's just how the magnetic field works. This is so interesting, and to be honest, I'm surprised why this technology has not been used in cubes before. And it turns out that there's nothing between these magnets. No matter how fast they turn in relation to each other, there's no friction. They are not connected by any spring nor by any details. Just air and magnetic force. Naturally, you have a magnet on each side, and the inside of this Rubik's cube looks like this. If we look at the components inside, we will see that a magnet also is located on each corner element. And here it is necessary in order for the cube to turn itself, and therefore it is attached to the magnets on the cross. Thus, the cube turns the edge instead of you. It also has extra magnets. I don't know the difference between them, maybe they are stronger or a little weaker in magnetic strength than those already installed in the central element. And they can be put here too. Also, in order to change the position of these magnets, there's such a toggle switch on each element. If you look closely, there are pluses and minuses. This toggle switch regulates the position of the magnet in the corner element. If we move it to minus, then the magnet sinks inwards, and the magnetic force from the central cross is weakened. And if we put on a plus, then the magnet gets out from the body of the element, and the magnetic attraction to the central cross becomes much stronger. This way we can adjust the strength of the magnets and accordingly the strength of the resistance and the strength of the automatic rotation. Customization can be so flexible. On the central element there are such steps that regulate the position of the magnet in the central element. We can simply lower it by scrolling or raise it. It turns out that the magnetic cushion is regulated simply by the fact that these magnets are either closer or farther from each other. The closer they are to each other, the stronger the magnet repulsion is. I brought these two elements closer to the camera to show you the honeycomb structure. It's like a honeycomb on each element. They are also needed so that these elements don't rub against each other so much. And I noticed that there are two more small magnets here. They are barely visible through the white plastic and are magnetized to each other. This is another extra magnet to improve cube control. So this cube is stuffed with magnets and it's so cool. It surprises me a lot. It is this technology that makes speedcubers pay that kind of money for the best Rubik's cubes. These cubes help to solve themselves in a few seconds or even fractions of a second. This is unbelievable. Folks, subscribe to the channel and turn on all notifications. I bought three more new awesome cubes, and in the next video I will try to solve them. Don't miss out! Let's try to get the cube into its normal state. It's so interesting. As you can see, wow, I figured out how to explain to you how magnetic levitation works. Look, the top face is not attached to the base now. When I scroll it, it will rise a little bit, because the magnets are repelled. We got our levitation magnets from the center, we won't use them now. Let's put the center back. And when we scroll the edge, you will clearly see how magnetic levitation works. The face rises with each turn and is fixed on its own. I have an idea. Now I will remove the retaining central magnets in absolutely all centers and see how the cube will turn just by the magnetic force. It will not be fixed in any way, you will see it. I'm removing the fixing magnet from absolutely every center, and now the cube is not fixed in any way and doesn't hold together in any way except for magnetic force. Okay, what do we have? The cube is not fixed, it is held only by magnets. And this is how the cube is turning on a magnetic cushion. As you can see, each face levitates at a full turn. I'm so interested in trying to solve the cube like that. Of course, it can fall apart at any moment, now it is held only by magnets. Let's do it, it's so entertaining! Wow, so cool! Great! Did you see it? It literally separates from the body of the cube. It's like each detail lives its separate life. Every face I wanted to say, oh, fell apart. Oh, it was a bad idea, we need to use central magnets, but you've seen how cool this is. Damn, I'm so excited to be honest. Now it's clear what a bag is for, so that it's all gathered in one place. Let's put everything here. In general, guys, I want to say it is amazing. I will now use this cube as my main one. I'll do a few hundred solvings and see how my time results change. And this is what the crust of this cube looks like. Inside there are the same magnets to which the corner element clinched, and it looks like this. Summing up this video, I want to say that I'm delighted with the cube building technologies of our time. In the 21st century, incredible things are happening with Rubik's cubes. They are magnetized, they can be sold in the air on their own, they become smarter than even me. This is wow! It's so interesting to know what will happen next, but it's also interesting what video will be next for you on this channel. So subscribe, don't miss the videos, see my other reviews about other puzzles and check the videos that you still didn't see on my channel. That's Cubastic, bye everyone and have a good time, see you soon in the next video.